Welcome back. My name is Patricia Regier. Did you know that YouTube, when you upload a video, there's some new settings that you need to check off, and specifically related to if you're doing anything related to AI? So we'll talk about it and let's jump in and I'll show you. All right. So here is when I jump into my my YouTube channel, and some of this information is the analytics through TubeBuddy, which I do purchase, and it's an add-on to my, it's attached to my YouTube account. So when I go to manage videos, I will link the video where I show you how to upload and some of the steps related to that. So this is an update to that video. And let's go to my latest video. And I'll show you around for what's so my video that I show that I share with you upload. I believe we look at title and then the title generator right here. That is a TubeBuddy add-on as well. I'm not paying for YouTube Premium right now, just to give you that context. So we have the description. It's public. There are no restrictions. Subtitles, I uploaded that specific file. I have end screen, maybe some cards I need to add. Now, again, TubeBuddy, I can double check and it will give me check marks that I have done all the things I can do, added to a playlist, reply to a comment, tags. I can show you that as well, like on Facebook, and chapters. Now, title is not between 20 and 70 characters, but when I did some title generator, this was one of the suggested titles. So AI is built in everywhere. What's interesting too, adding chapters here is a different option than what I have done. So it is recognizing the chapters right here in the video itself. And I'm just going to take a look here too for the videos. And when I go into this one, it will often jump into ads, and that's not even, that's just part of what YouTube does. But it used to show hashtags right here or somewhere around here. And I think that's dropped off. So when we're talking about tags, that is different. And I'll show you again where that is. So I will explore this yet too with the ad chapters. TubeBuddy also has a thumbnail analyzer. This isn't intended to showcase TubeBuddy. It's not sponsored, but that's what you're seeing here. I have it part of playlists here as well. And no, it's not made for kids. Even though it doesn't matter, kids watch this video. This particular video isn't sponsored, doesn't have, free product or anything like that. Now, I might need to check mark that if, for example, I was talking about my book, which is when I'm not sharing screen, is behind me. So I'll share that later. Then I would check off this box. So for this video, I will likely do that. And my book, since I'm mentioning it and I'm pulling it in front of me so you can see it, is The Online Shift, 101 Pro Tips for Online Facilitators, Workplace Trainers, Virtual Speakers. And so now I'll check that box for this video. And I should say it's available on Amazon. I'll share the links below. Thank you for checking that out. If you are interested, it's a great gift as well. All right. So what I wanted to share with you specifically today is this altered content. So with the video that I'm sharing here, I talk about AI generated podcasts in that recent video. And that video also shares a portion from the AI conversation. So this is interesting. The video podcasts the podcast that I created with that AI tool, it's based on my own content. but it's two people that aren't real and they're talking. So those podcasts, I have checked this box. Yes, technically, it's not real. It's AI generated. The video that I'm talking about, generated podcasts, I checked it because there is a segment. So there could be a debate. What's really AI? It's not fake news. It's about my real content. I'm not misrepresenting anything. But the conversation in those podcasts are two people that aren't real people, but they probably pulled voices from real people. So, you know, basically too, there are some videos that you might see in the corner that says altered content. That's basically saying fake news potentially. So some things that you are watching, it can be obvious or it might not be obvious to everyone that it is altered content. Even if I was using a generated, so this is interesting. I wonder too, let's stop for a second. And if here in, I'm recording through Zoom, not to take this too many places. If I am talking through an avatar, does this also count as where I have to check mark yes? Because technically this isn't my face, but it is altered content. It's still really me talking. I'm not, and we have a lot of tools now where we can do text to talk. We can, it'll be our words, but in a course, it might be an AI voice. So all of that technically is related to AI content. So I'm going to share again and show you. So right here, the altered content, do any of the following describe your content? Makes a real person appear to say or do something they didn't say or do. With the AI podcast, technically, alters footage of a real life event or place, basically fake news, you know, generates a realistic looking scene that didn't actually occur. And again, that avatar, maybe, I don't know. So it can be debatable, but you can go through examples here with YouTube and look at it further. I will, in selecting yes, adds a disclosure to your content. And so that might deter people from watching your video and it might be legitimate content. Okay, so in a short, altered or synthetic content, for examples, it doesn't apply to beauty filters. That's good. Altering content to replace a face. So that does replace for that avatar in Zoom. A backdrop doesn't apply. So it's good that they have the doesn't and does here. I think those podcasts do qualify. That is something important. And even though this is something newer, with your new uploads, you need to be checking this off. And you can go through some of your old videos, especially the ones that are the most popular and still being viewed quite a bit. It wouldn't hurt to go in and make this adjustment. So I have automatic chapters and key moments. Featured places, that's more if it's travel, automatic concept. So this is new, it's experiment. It's not even saying beta. So unfamiliar terms without leaving the video. So that's really interesting too. Potentially making it a little bit more accessible or helping people learn through the content. This is really important with the tags. So that's not hashtags. And it's showing people are looking up Notebook LM interactive mode. People are looking up my name. Some of these others aren't as popular for search terms, but they're describing it. Maybe they could become search terms. Okay, so those are the tags. Even without The TubeBuddy makes it easier so I can see what people are looking for, but I can still be searching through YouTube and writing them here, even without this help option. I have my video language and recording date. I don't always do that. Video location, that would be more if it's like my other channel. I have some travel videos from our trip to Iceland, and then I would put where in Iceland. Standard YouTube license, distribution everywhere. I'm allowing embedding. Part of that is when I want to add it into my own blog or even my LinkedIn to share it. May even be for Facebook as well. So that's something you have to consider. It does allow other people to share my video, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. Allows remixing. If it shares the information a little bit farther, I do have this video as educational tutorial. It does give type. That's getting, and I can add how to. I'm not adding some of this information, but maybe that would be helpful for people to find it. Anytime I make a change, I can click save. And academic system, I'm in Canada. Level, my educational, it's not necessarily, I mean, I could select beginner, intermediate, or advanced. Maybe I'll select beginner for that one. And, or maybe, I don't know then if people aren't beginners, if they would still, they definitely would still find it helpful. So you have to make those decisions for yourself. Comments are on, basic moderation, assort the latest comments on the top. And you can decide how to show how many people like it or not. If you end up with one of your older videos, a lot of people liking it, then there's definitely going to be some that people don't like it as well. So those are choices too, if that matters. I'm going to click save. So that's a little bit of an update on some of those settings, in particular, the new AI option to check that off as well. And then you can go into any of these on the left, analytics, and I could be looking at, right now, this is a very recent video. This might be curious too, because hours are spent on recording, editing, uploading process. And for a lot of creators, they're not getting any money. It's an added value. They're sharing. It's a creative outlet. For those that are part of YouTube's monetization, when they get to a certain number of subscribers and views, then they can make a little bit. Depending on how many views, and the more people watch the commercials or ads, then I think that increases it. People skip ahead. That's always a choice, and there's no cost to the person watching it. So this is a very recent video, and so that's not going to be showing a lot, but I can look at audience, and it's because it's, and this is typical. Most of the people watching tutorials on my channel are not subscribed. And I certainly appreciate if you do subscribe, like, comment. What do you think? What are questions you have? Share it with others as well. And where people are watching from in their language or with subtitles. So it's the overview. You want to go to details is where you're going to be making those changes to the settings. So I hope this is helpful to you to feature some of the new settings that are available in YouTube. I'll link the other YouTube more about uploading, a simple way to add to your channel. And thanks again for checking this out. My name is Patricia Regier.